My name is André da Silva. I'm the University of Georgia Vegetable Extension Specialist, and today we're going to talk about irrigation scheduling for vegetable production. Currently, there are 6 methods of irrigation scheduling. However, the University of Georgia only recommends 4 of those methods, and today we're going to talk about these methods of irrigation scheduling.
The first method of irrigation scheduling is the systematic method, in which water is applied every day for a certain amount of time, or every day the same amount of volume. To do that, a grower needs an irrigation panel such as this one, where it's going to be programmed the time that the water is going to be applied or the volume that should be applied during an irrigation event. Here at the University of Georgia, we do recommend the systematic method of irrigation scheduling as long as it's followed by a blue dye test, in which we're going to track how much water should be applied or how long your irrigation event should be to do not supply water below the crop, the root zone of your crop. To do that, you can contact your extension office or your extension agent, and we're going to help you to perform this blue dye test.
The second method of irrigation scheduling is the crop evapotranspiration, in which we require weather condition and stage of crop development to determine volume of water for your next irrigation event. The reason we need the stage of the crop development is because plants that are in this size or even fruiting like that, we require much more water than plants that were recently transplanted in the field. And here at the University of Georgia, we do have an irrigation app that will provide you this volume of water according to your planting date, location in the state, and crop. Particularly, this irrigation method or this irrigation scheduling method is very accurate, simple, and strongly recommended by the University of Georgia.
The third method of irrigation scheduling is the soil moisture sensor method. This method requires the growers to know the soil physical properties in their farms, such as field capacity and permanent wilting point. Field capacity is the maximum water that your soil can hold, while the permanent wilting point is the minimum water that your soil holds that is available for your plant. The difference between the field capacity and the permanent wilting point will give you the soil available water, which is the water that your plants will uptake. Once you set up a threshold in this available water, you can start to determine your irrigation schedule on another ones when will be your irrigation events. To determine the moisture in your soil, we're going to need to use soil moisture sensors. Here is an example of a fixed soil moisture sensor, which is installed in an old bell pepper field and collect data every 15 minutes. So this sensor gives you an history of the moisture along the time in your field. On the other hand, here we have a portable soil moisture sensor that you can bring to the field with you, and you can use in several fields to determine the moisture in your soil and how much water should be applied for your crop. There are advantages and disadvantages of using each of these soil moisture sensors, and this will depend on your budget, your area, and your time to move from field to field.
Finally, the last method of irrigation scheduling is the water budget method, in which we're going to combine the copper evapotranspiration and the soil moisture sensor method to apply water, only to supply how much water was lost by the plant, or in other words, uptake by plants, and do not apply more water than your soil can hold, in other words, your field capacity. This is the optimum one, because you will never apply more water than your crop, the soil can hold, or more water than your plants need.
So, if you still have any questions regarding irrigation scheduling for vegetable production, contact your extension agent or your extension office, and here at the University of Georgia, we can help you to decide the irrigation method or which method of irrigation scheduling best fit your requirements, your area, or your budget.